Evoland 2, A Slight Case of Spacetime Continuum Disorder, Episode 19, Windless Climb. Previously on Evoland 2, A Slight Case of Spacetime Continuum Disorder, our heroes have to climb a mountain in order to do whatever they need to.
Yeah. The disciples of the prophets. Clearly. Need to be able to handle anything that can be thrown at them. Yeah. I'd best not get caught on one of those spikes. It'll probably kill me. Yeah. Because if my Mega Man lore, or rather the knowledge of it, is consistent, it would mean death. When I need it. Oh, I can destroy them with my sword beams. Clearly wearing the wrong color trousers. Because if I was, it would certainly match what I was feeling like doing right now. Ugh. Just there! Let's see if I can take both of them out at the same time. Oh, I just needed to charge it up to a level 1 focus attack. Yes! More kiddie power! Although I don't see how that's particularly relevant, considering that they go down 1-2 hits anyway. Perhaps if it gets to when the laws of physics, rather the laws of video games, switch to JRPG. Yeah, I don't think jumping high as I can would be a good idea there. Oh, the appearing and disappearing platforms. Just like in Mega Man. sad that they... that these big Japanese game developers... practically... defecated on the franchises that make them a success. Yeah, that's the problem with success. Sometimes you let it get to your head. You either have to start all over again, or you die. Turn my back for 1 second, and we come back. Aiming for the one that I couldn't kill with the sword alone. Yeah. How hard can it be? Harder than you think! Yeah. Finally. Now to get up here and... start clearing out the vermin. Oh, and climb this way. For some reason, this feels like the... barely made that. It's a chest, I want it, and... yeah! Again. Well, thankfully there aren't any spikes, because if there were, I would be dead. Let me guess, when I've collected enough of them, I'll be able to fight some giant flame-breathing tortoise. I'm guessing that... Yeah, leg it before they'd all disappear. Yeah, force as much. Yeah! Yeah, you have to try harder than that. Yeah!
Anomaly someday, I'll be internationally fit recognized! But seeing as I don't know what it looks like, for now, all I can do is search.
You might want to do something about your disproportionately sized breasts. They're quite a handicap for doing stuff like this. Meanwhile, I'll have to figure out the correct sequence to jumping around here. All I can be thankful for is there aren't any spikes below. There aren't any penalties for falling too far. That's one advantage this world has over reality, as I know it. Jump up. A simple sequence of platforms which appear and disappear. Here it goes back and forth. Ah. Yeah, that's where I'm going. Playing a Dark Souls game, except less fun. And yeah, I know. It's a twisted sort of fun. Ah, yeah, that's where I was going wrong. Heh. Finally! And I find a way back to the time period that Menos is from. I can make some... rather have someone else make some more Oricon gear. Well, the smug gear. This time is the best that's available. Except for the sword. Which, compared to the sword I already have, is a downgrade. Sword out of these. Yeah. Why does that not make me fancy? For compiling the outtake video first. I deleted the wrong footage. Anyway, all that I did was leap up on there, jump off on the appearing and disappearing platforms, bounce up, and then walk into the save points near those spiders, which you'll see within the next few seconds. My apologies for my incompetence. Not much more. Yeah! More dangerous than the last one, because at least there weren't any spikes. Don't know what I did, but this red goop is mine. Will come in handy next time I need a red potion. I can go outside now. This is the place, and can't get up here yet. Or rather over there. Right, let's see what else is here. Ooh, what's this? Fina? Yeah!
Hello, don't tell me.
Let's use it to fly to the top of the pyramid.
I don't think it's such a good idea.
once, I agree wholeheartedly with Miss Fina. This device looks... dangerous.
Well, if there was a safer path, we wouldn't have climbed up here in the first place.
Yes, another way. Of course. That is what we find.
And this way is?
I must admit, I know of no other way.
Oh no! Menos!
Got a safer machine?
I could maybe give it a shot. But it's only to make you happy, girl.
It's the only option we have.
And I like it! Yes! Rain bullets as my enemies! Collect their ghouls! Obliterate them! Yeah.
Ooh. So that's how it works here.
Oh.
That's how that works. I wonder what happens if I use Menos. You know what? Let's find out. These are better protected than the pumpkin. Enough, as they can still be destroyed. Good job their weapons built into this. Air bike. Hopefully, I don't need misspells or zoos to drive this around authentically. Yes! Feast on the power of Fina!
Send me something stronger.
Ah, that's more like it! Was that the best you could do? I'm disappointed. Never mind death from above. What about death from right in front of you? Means, but it means that it'll be slightly harder for me to kill. I mean, be killed by them! To make it slightly easier for me to kill them. Oh, you know what I mean! So much fun! Plenty of things for me to kill. Much anger for me to
airborne resistance gets stronger? What awaits them at the top of the Pyramid of the Prophet? Will they just let them take the Stone of Time? Find out next time on Evoland 2, a slight case of space-time continuum disorder. And let's hope there's less technical difficulties this time. Yeah. Way to go, editor. You just made a mess of things, once again.